Well, let's go to Ned Baum. Ned, a flood warning has been issued there at Beenleigh.
Yeah, that's right, Sam. The Logan and Albert Rivers are expected to reach moderate level flood level by late this evening. That comes after rainfalls between 100 millimetres and 200 millimetres in the catchment. In places like Cedar Creek, that received 309 millimetres, and Mount Tambourine, that received 252. Seven dams across the southeast are currently spilling, and releases from Somerset into Wivenhoe started this afternoon and will continue for the next couple of days. At this stage, there are no more scheduled releases, but with any more amount of rain, the risk of flooding increases. Shirtless, shoeless, and now carless.
Tried to get through the water thinking it wasn't as deep as it is, and before we knew it, the car was gone and I was on the roof calling the 000 to try and get us out.
Connor Sessions thought his ute could withstand the deluge on 2nd Avenue in Marsden.
Price to pay now, lesson learnt. Lucky no one was hurt.
The Logan thoroughfare, one of many swallowed by the more than 100 millimetres of rain in the past day.
This morning at about 6 a.m, this had water across the bridge, but it wasn't covered. Then within an hour, it was covered.
Taking dozens of motorists by surprise.
Every car here is just cars that have tried to go through.
Yeah, and there's been maybe 15 that have been towed away.
Others were left stuck, waiting for waters to recede.
I didn't see the water, actually.
Your car's just not starting now?
Yeah, now not starting. I called my friend, to get some help.
Clark's Road at Logan Home, another reminder of the unpredictable nature of summer storms.
A car in the flood water, the police, and someone walking the road.
Dad, let's go home and get the fishing rods, there's fish jumping.
At Eagleby too, drivers ignored risks. A silver Mazda no match as roads turned to rivers. Swiftwater rescue crews and police searched for a reportedly missing man at Meadowbrook, but it was a false alarm, tying up vital resources.
State emergency services received over 700 calls in the last 24-hour period.
With heavy rain set to continue for the next 24 hours, there remains a high risk of flash flooding across the southeast. Motorists are being urged to avoid flooded roads.
Now is not the time to be out and about. If you're in parts of Queensland receiving torrential rain at the moment, the best thing you can do is stay at home.
We've got a lot of creek systems. They're now becoming wet, and there is that still ongoing risk of heavy rainfall. So that risk of localised flash flooding will also remain a risk.
Brisbane was forecast to be in the firing line, but so far has been spared. The greatest risk for flash flooding is now on the Sunshine Coast tomorrow morning.
The majority of the areas hit is probably the Caloundra and Kawana sort of suburbs.
For those not willing to take any chances, sandbags are available at all SES depots.
We're not taking any risks, so we all come together and get it done.
Could we see levels reach what they did during the course of the February 22 events? At the moment, it's looking fairly low, but I guess we've still got 24 hours to play out.
But in true Queensland fashion, be prepared for anything. Ned Baum, 7 News.